lovelies, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new. For today's video, we are doing my second Halloween look of the year, which is going to be a kind of Cruella De Veil inspired look. It's actually my second time filming this because I did a different look and I absolutely hated it. If you're Instagram a beauty guru, you will know. Not saying I'm a beauty guru, but you know. And I'm in a dressing gown because it's actually quite cold. This isn't my dressing gown, so if I get makeup on it, which I may already have, I could be slightly killed by the person who dressing gown is. But it's fine. So without further ado, I'm gonna get into this video because I'm actually excited to do this one. It's a bit different to the last one. So yeah, let's go. So the first thing I'm going to be taking is my Moon Creations body crayon, just to draw the outline under here of where the like Cruella De Veil dog style is going to start. I have a reference picture on my phone here, because I don't know how to pronounce her name. Sorry, I couldn't see her name, but I can now. It's Katie Holmes, I think her name is. I'll put her Instagram link down below anyway, who this look is inspired by. So who is your favourite Disney character villain? Because mine is actually Cruella De Veil. I do love her. I've gone a bit too far there. That's okay. But yeah, she has to be one of my favourite villains ever in the world. And also Ursula, I think that's how you say her name, from The Little Mermaid. Really like her as well. Okay, so I've done my eyebrows and one eye off camera, and I'm now going to do this eye. And the eyeshadow palette I'm using, obviously, is the James Charles X Morphe palette, and the three shades I am taking from this palette are Social Blade, Daddy, and Ringlight, which is this shade and these two green shades down here. I'm actually going to be starting off with Daddy and just packing that into my outer corner. I should zoom you in a bit, actually, sorry. Just like that. And just packing this shade on, just like this, into the outer corner, and then I'm going to be taking Social Blade on another brush, and I'm just going to be blending that like so into the colours. I'm bringing Social Blade into the crease. God, I had to think what it's called then. Who is excited for Halloween? I'm so excited for Halloween. It's like one of my favourite holidays of the year, other than Christmas, because I love Christmas, because I love Christmas dinner is my favorite, and being able to give to people, I also love that. I also love giving. I'm really excited when I give people presents. I'm like, oh my god, like, you know, I'm like, I want to see their reaction, but obviously all the time you can't, but like if it's friends and things. But I just love buying people things for Christmas. It's one of my favorite things to do. I'm normally super organized, but this year I'm not, and I'm like saying it as it were like in December, but I always have my list of what I'm gonna get people done, and then I always buy my presents around November time, so then I'm done and don't have to stress around Christmas, which does sound a bit odd. I'm just gonna take a little bit more of Daddy just to darken that up again, but I just love doing it that way. And then I'm just gonna take Social Blade and just apply that all over the lid. I'm not really doing a cut crease. It kind of looks like I have on here, but I haven't. Isn't that cool? I know. But yeah, Christmas and Halloween. I love Halloween. I'm taking my nephew and niece out this year, 100%. Except my, did I say, I think I said this in my last video. If I didn't, I'm so sorry. If I did, then this won't be in it. Or, I don't know. But I'm going to say it again. My nephew's going as Donald Trump. And I was like, brilliant. And my niece is going as a panda. I'm gonna dress up, I don't care. I'm taking them out with a friend and I'm gonna dress up. They don't have to, but I am, because I love it. Oh, I somehow got black on my hand and I don't know why. I'm just gonna bring that up because I really like eyeshadow that goes right up close to the brow bone. When you do like these sort of like looks, I don't know if that's just me, but I really like it. Oh, my phone's ringing. What do I do? Oh, I'm out of focus. So sorry for that phone call. Not that you knew. I'm next going to be taking Ringlight and applying that onto my lid, just with my finger, because I find that's the best way to apply shimmery shadows. Just like that. I love this shade. It's got a bit green from my being on my finger, then on my smile lid, and then back on. But I love this shade. Oh, he's back. So now I'm going to do the white paint here, and I'm just going to be taking a Snazaroo white paint that looks like this, and I'm just going to be taking a sponge, or you can use a brush, it's completely up to you. And I'm just going to be applying that to my face, and then my neck and chest. These paints smell really weird. Like, they don't smell weird, they smell like childhood, because, you know, when you used to get your face painted when you were younger, this is what they remind me of. Apply it to the neck and chest area. I'm literally just taking a brush and just doing it like this, just so I can get an even coverage. Is that applying to the chin, or is that a shadow? Yeah, it's applying to the chin. I was like, what is it doing? And I'm just going to come to about here, just where my shoulders are, because I don't want to go too far down. Okay, so now I'm going to do the dots, like the Dalmatian spots, and I'm just taking a sort of brush like this. I would normally use this for powder, and then I'm just taking a black Snazaroo face paint. So I'm just going to keep that in black, get my mirror. I'm going to do the chest area first and my reference pictures. So I'm just kind of going to dot. Can you see that? Oh, it didn't come up very well. But I think if I just go over it a bit, I'm going to add black eyeshadow over the top as well. There's our first spot. How do I do this? Should I do this like randomly or like... I'm like, how should I do this? Do some on the face, ready? Are these too big to be Dalmatian spots? I don't think they are. I'll do maybe like a smaller one like that. Like on the chin. And to add some black face paint just to, not face paint, eyeshadow, sorry. Just to mattify these spots down a bit. And just make them that tiny bit more pigmented. See what that does? Oh, I like that. I think I'll just put like a little bit on. I really like this. Oh wow. In my reference picture, she's just, oh, I haven't done the nose. I'm just gonna take this same brush and apply the black to like my nose. I'm quite scared to do this. I might just leave it like that. Well, that's not really a dog's nose, is it? But I quite like it, just like the tip. So I might just leave mine like this. Because I quite like it just being like the little tip of the nose. I don't know. Now for the fun part, the fake blood. The fake blood I'm using is the Krylon Fake Blood by Nick Dunman, which is Pigs Might Fly South. This is a dark blood, by the way. I'm just going to apply that to my lips because that's what she has done in the picture. Oh, that feels really weird. Oh, I'm not in focus. Come on, camera, pick me up. There we go. Oh, this feels weird. No, actually, that's a lie. I think I put flake blood on my lips for over something. I want like it to drip from the mouth, so I'm just gonna like dot this on a bit. That's actually quite a nice lip colour. Oh, it's dripping. And then I'm assuming this part can kind of be a bit messy. I'm sorry if you can't understand a word I'm saying. And then I'm just gonna take some and hold it at my mouth. Let it drip like that. Trying to get a tight bloody eye off. Look, that's so attractive. Trying to get fake blood to drip, I think, is the most tedious part of special effects makeup. I really hate this blood can go in my mouth because it's in my mouth. Oh! Oh no, I got it on the dressing gown. I'm gonna get shot if you find that. You can't see, I'm so sorry. Such a bad YouTuber. This, my lovelies, is the finished look. If you did like this video, please give it a massive thumbs up and please hit that big red subscribe button down below. And I will see you in another Halloween tutorial. I love you all very much and I'll see you soon. Bye. Do you love me?